Does he understand that they're all leaking and he can't trust any of them?
Of course he did. Of course he does. And he never trusts anyone to begin with. One of the people in that group is his son-in-law, the guy married to his daughter, and he apparently doesn't trust his son-in-law. You know, when he sued me at one point, you know, he sued me because I had anonymous sources, and he wanted to know who my anonymous sources were. And then they deposed me for 2 days during that suit. And at one point during the course of the deposition, his lawyers began reading a list to me of Trump insiders and people outside the organization that he was close to find out if I had spoken to them. And after he got to about the fifth person, I realized they were on a fishing expedition. I said, I'm not going to answer this question. They said, you're under oath. You have to. I said, well, I'm not going to reveal my sources. My lawyers intervened, and we moved on. And what's ironic about that is he's employing the same principle right now in the White House. He is trying to ferret out anonymous sources. And the man who's doing this is someone who's spent the last five decades anonymously offering gossip and malignant rumors to every reporter in New York and Washington about his family, about business competitors, about celebrities and politicians, in order to damage them and enhance himself. He's adopted fake personas. He's used the name John Miller and John Barron to promote these stories. He got that from his father. His father used to go around in New York under the persona of Mr. Green to anonymously look at properties. This is an old Trump tool of the trade. They've been doing it forever. And he's now going after people who have used the same devices he has because he's profoundly paranoid.